हेलो गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल जावा एक्सपर्ट ट्यूटोरियल। सो गाइस, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सुपर एंड दिस कीवर्ड। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद सुपर कीवर्ड। सुपर इज अ रिजर्व कीवर्ड इन जावा, दैट इज वी कांट यूज इट एज एन आइडेंटिफायर। सो गाइस, आइडेंटिफायर इज नथिंग बट अ नेम ऑफ वेरिएबल, क्लास, मेथड, पैकेज, इंटरफेस एक्सेट्रा। एंड रिजर्व कीवर्ड्स आर प्री डिफाइंड which have a unique meaning and functionality, which means they cannot be used as a variable name, class name, method name or interface name, etc. Okay. Super keyword is used to refer super class instance as well as static members. Next, super keyword is used to access methods of the parent class. So guys, you can access parent class data members and methods from child class using super keyword. Okay. Next, super keyword can be used any number of time. So there is no limitation for super keyword. So you can use super keyword multiple times. Let's understand with the practical example. Okay. So guys, this is the example of super keyword. Okay. So in this example, I declared two classes, parent and child. Child class extends parent class. Okay. Inside parent class, first, I declare two variables. First is instance variable and second is static variable A and B. And assigning value 10, 20. Okay. And after that, I define a method M. Okay. And in child class, I define M1 method. Inside the M1 method, I am trying to changing the value of variable A using super keyword. Okay, that means this is the parent class variable A. You can see. Okay, and after that I am just trying to printing the value of A and doing the same thing for static variables, and after that I am using super keyword and accessing parent class method. Okay, this is M method. So I am trying to accessing a method from child class, okay, using super keyword. And inside the main method, I just creating the object of child class and calling M1 method. Okay, so let's see what will be the output. Okay, so guys, you can see A equals to 100, B equals to 100, and M method invoke. So guys, if you have to access parent class data members and methods from child class, so you can use super keyword. Okay. Next, this keyword. Okay. This is a reserved keyword in Java. This keyword is used to refer current class instance as well as static members. This keyword is used to access methods of the current class. This keyword can be used any number of times. Okay. So let's understand with the practical example of this keyword. So guys, this is the example of this keyword. Here, I create only one class, student. Okay, that means this is our current class. And declaring two variables, instance variables A equals to 10 and static variable B equals to 20. And after that, I declare two methods, M1 method and M2 method. Inside the M1 method, I am just trying to printing a message, M1 method. And inside the M2 method, I am trying to changing the value of A using this keyword. Okay, here this dot A equals to 100. After that, I am trying to printing the value of a and doing the same thing for a static variable, as you can see. Okay, so I am just trying to changing the value of a and b using this keyword. Okay. After that, I am calling m1 method using this keyword. And inside the main method, I am just creating the object of student class and calling the m2 method. Okay, when we run this program, then let's see what will be the output. So guys, as you can see, a equals to 100 and b equals to 600 and m1 method invoked. Okay, so guys, if you have to access current class data members and methods, so you can use this keyword. And if you have to access parent class data members and methods, so you can use super keyword. Okay, so guys, thank you for watching this video. See you in the next video. Bye bye, take care.